Good evening, everyone. How are we all doing? It's your boy PW doing another live reaction to, yeah, you guessed it. Hopefully you've understood how all this currently works on screen and everything at this moment in time. As I mentioned before, right at the bottom underneath my video right here, you will see the song we're going to go across today. And today's particular live reaction is going to be to James Arthur. And it's going to be his xFactor journey, fundamentally. We already did his audition, so that's all up in the channel at the moment. But now we're going to move on to boot camp. And I'm looking forward to this. I am, because it's sort of going back in time. Obviously, it's been a good 10, 11 years now that I've been following him since early doors. And it'd be really interesting to see, obviously, now what I know of his vocal capability, to now to sort of seeing what he was like back then and seeing if we noticed much of a difference, etc. But before we get into that, check out on the right hand side, or this side, the latest live reactions that I've done. So the first one that we did on Thursday night was for Aidan Martin. That was the cover of Best Part. Then for Friday, we did the Olivia Rodrigo Driver's License, which is absolutely fantastic. Really enjoyed doing that, and that was a lot of fun. And then tonight, good old Saturday, we are going to be doing James Arthur and his boot camp. So, without further ado, let's go into the live reaction segment. Before I do, if any of you are interested, just below my camera again, but above the link for today's title, you will see my Twitch, my YouTube, and my Twitter tags. If you're interested, please follow them, please send me a like, whatever it might be, really, really good. So without further ado, let's crack on. Transition, smooth. So there we are. Good old Nicole, straight on the bat. So let's give this a go, and let's go back in time, shall we? Let's do this.
Sing your heart out. A million love songs later, and here I am trying to tell you that I care a million love songs later.
Holy shoot. Oh my goodness, how different does he look? It's from a perspective of he's grown from a young man to obviously full blown man now, if that makes any sense. But you know what I'm referring to. Obviously he's grown, he's developed as a person, and obviously this was when he was quite young. Obviously quite a lot different. I think I remember in his podcast, the Geordie podcast, he was saying on his first audition he looked quite lethargic, and to be fair, looking back at the pictures, he did. I just thought I'd noticed that straight off the bat. It's he looks completely different. He's got a beard now.
Oh, and here I am. Oh, million love songs to leave. Oh, here I am.
I love the fact that, wait a minute, am I correct in this? Did he get a standing ovation? I'm sure he did. Anyway, one thing I always noticed, and again, there was obviously lots to it, and James talked about in the Geordie podcast, that he was on quite a lot of medication, went through a lot of anxiety. He had a couple of numbers of medics on his phone. And all this sort of, I'm smiling because I'm obviously remembering obviously the things, and it was quite an insight. And I mentioned the Geordie podcast, guys, please check it out. I'll put the link in the description, hopefully, and then you can go and check it out. Incredible listen, genuinely, hand on heart, is incredible listen, and it really sort of allows you to get to know James a lot more than maybe you thought you did. And James opens up quite openly about the things that sort of went on that may not have been discussed. Obviously, his book mentions quite a lot of things, but this is a true true insight to James. So check it out. Incredible listen. And yeah, go and do it. So let's go. But yeah, I don't know many persons, actually, from all the years I watched X Factor, that got a standing ovation at boot camp. Anyway, let's go.
That was the best moment of my life, by far.
Oh my god, do you remember this? Do you remember this segment? I do. And no disrespect to the chaps on the stage, if you are watching, I doubt you are. I'm sure you've got better things to do than watch my live reactions. And of course, this is no hate, this is no criticism. For me, on that stage, there was only one person that should have gone through. Personally, I didn't like the others. And that's just my opinion. Some people might not like it, some people will, but hey, that's me. I thought James stood out, and it, when we come into this in a minute and you listen to this, hopefully you'll hear where I'm coming from, because he was in a different class in my opinion. But anyway, let's go.
Between the lies of fear and fame, you begin to wonder why you came.
And where did I go wrong? I lost a friend somewhere along in the bitterness.
And I would have stayed up with you all night if I'd known how to save a life.
Okay, first initial reaction. Sorry if I pulled some faces. I'm gonna be brutal. I'm gonna be honest. James smashed that. I don't think there was much competition there. Yes, obviously the chaps have obviously gone past a certain stage and they've got through to boot camp and they're being assessed because they do have capability and skill. I'm not hating on those chaps. I'm not saying that they can't sing. But for me, I clearly heard a difference between James and the other two. And I never quite understood why they were all considered at the time, but that's just my opinion, and that's what I'm here for on my live reactions. So just that initial segment, you can hear the class, the difference in James's voice.
Let him know that you know best. After all, you do know best. Try to slip past his defense without giving in those ends.
Oh, lay down the list of what is wrong, the things you told him all along. Pray to God he hears you, and I pray to God he hears you.
Oh. See what I mean? It's just the tone, the ability to do the runs, do the trills, do the hymn, the husky rawness to his voice, and you know, all this sort of stuff. It's just I can't quite hit it other than those things that I've mentioned. And you listen to that first segment and it wasn't very confident. And again, maybe that's that particular chap's style. Again, not hating, just trying to give a reaction to it. But James right there is just smashed it, and you can see the reactions on the judges' faces. Anyway.
Oh, where did I go wrong? I lost a friend somewhere along in the bitterness, and I would just say it all.
To be honest, it's been probably the most emotional.
Okay, so again, that segment, that boot camp segment, for me, is clear-cut winner, in my opinion. And anyway, going back to it, look how much James has changed again. It's funny, actually, on his couple of his lives recently, for some bizarre reason, some people have mentioned, like, Botox and things like that. It's mad. He has confirmed he hasn't ever had it. And in fact, on some of his lives, he talks about how fresh he looks. He looks like a newborn. And it just cracks me up. And that's the sort of character that he is. He's I digress. But look how different he looks. It's insane. It's insane. In fact, he did admit he's had his teeth done, and then I think he got his nose done because he did a lot of scrapping. Again, it's all mentioned in the Geordie podcast. Check it out.
The testing time of my life.
Do I want to go into this? Oh, we're here now. Come on, let's do boot camp and let's do judges' houses together, shall we?
I went to that first audition with a hell of a lot of self-doubt.
That always baffled me. And I'm not just saying this because I'm a fan of James and followed him and done all this stuff for him or any of that stuff. I'm not. I'm really not. I'm just being truthful and honest with my channel. When he said that he was quite nervous, and I'm sure he was. I'm not going to doubt the guy. Obviously, at the end of that's how he was feeling, and that's how he's saying he is. But when watching that audition, I never got that vibe. All as I saw was confidence, ability, and he smashed it out of the park. He absolutely smashed it out of the park, and that's why I guess sort of mentioned that segment, because I just think to myself, I mean, if that's what you're like when you're nervous, you either got massive ability to sort of put that facade on and control your nervousness, or you just get taken to a whole new world with your music. It's insane, because the amount of persons that we've come across on the X Factor, or you see on competitions, where they're nervous, they forget their words, they don't hit the correct notes, they're out of tune, out of temper, you know, all those sorts of things that you regularly see. But the fact that James said he was nervous, yeah, it just really surprised me, because I thought he was probably one of his most controlled and confident single auditions. But that's just my opinion.
If anyone dares touch what you do, because it's so good.
It was a big day for me, and I was so happy to get through it. Taking part in the X Factor is a big deal, because I'm putting who I am as a person out there, which is something I've been quite afraid of doing. I spent a lot of my life being quite paranoid about my appearance. I didn't think that I had the full package, you know, your typical pop star. To get through would make me feel that I'm definitely worth something.
Hey, James.
Alright.
How you doing?
I'm nervous, obviously. Performing in front of you two is like a fairy tale. So.
Can I ask you what it would mean to you going through to live shows?
I've never wanted anything more than this in my entire life.
Wow. It's incredible. And maybe they'll mention it in a minute about obviously not wanting to go back to his bed sit, etc. But yeah, I remember this. It's crazy. Proper crazy.
So it would mean the world to me.
Take it away then.
Turn down the light. Turn down the bed. Turn down these voices inside my head.
Wow.
Lay down with me.
So, right there, let's go back. Look at Nicole's face. And this is one of the things I've always talked about, and I really appreciated with James as an artist, is he has a way of connecting, singing a song, doing an audition, really getting people on board and feeling it. It's hard to explain, but where you see and hear all these songs all the time, people just either just sing and they're like, yeah, okay, we'll sing a song, all that sort of stuff, blah blah blah, and there's just no real feeling or emotion to it, or there's no real I'm going to take you on a journey. Whereas I've always found it with James ever since the beginning, and I'm going to say it again, in fact he's got better and better as he's done it, incredible artist, where you feel what he's singing and you feel like he gets taken on a journey, and so you get taken on a journey from his singing, And right here, you're just about to see Nicole Scherzinger immediately get sucked in by James's capability and the raw emotion in his voice right now is just, you can't teach it, sorry, you can't.
Turn down these voices inside my head. Lay down with me, tell me no lies. Just hold me close, don't patronize me. Don't patronize me. And I can make you love me if you don't. And I can make your heart feel something it won't.
It's just insane. The emotion, the rawness, it's just, it comes out so much in James's singing. And that, in fact, when I say that hasn't changed, it has changed from then to now, but it's even more so because the lyrics to the songs that he now writes, coupled with the vocals, the emotion, etc., makes it even more profound and more unique than a lot of artists out there. And I mean, bearing in mind this was way back then, so it's raw. It is raw talent, honestly.
And here in the dark, in these final hours, I will lay down my heart, and I feel the power, but you don't. No, you don't. No, you don't.
Wow.
James.
It's mad.
He seems like he doesn't have a choice. Mm-hmm. There's a pain that's there. It's a real pain.
Mm-hmm. I used that energy to put across the message in the song, so.
I know that's a personal message to you, isn't it?
Yeah, it kind of is, yeah.
There's something in that voice, right?
It's incredible. But
incredible. His words. That voice is incredible.
That anxiety can take over. Should that happen, it could turn into a negative.
Yeah.
Like that.
Good.
Oh, no. Oh, we don't want adverts.
Grammar and spelling are important. But
sorry.
If you want to write essays that inspire...
It's annoying. There we go. Let's be more professional.
I realised that the show's never really had someone like me. There's always a bit of self-doubt in the back of my mind that I'm not what people want to see.
And I can make you love me.
To put me through would be a little bit of a gamble. So I feel like my fate's hanging in the balance a little bit.
See, he even knew it then. He's such a honest chap, and he's... real, and that's, again, that's another thing, the reason why I like him as an artist. It's and that's never changed. He's never wanted to conform to what society wants of him, and he's quite rightly said then, you know, this is me, and I'm a bit of a gamble for what people might want to listen to. And he's real, and he's got such a wise head on him even back then to say, you know, such a thing. And well, we all know the outcome, don't we? So, anyway, let's look at the decision, because I can't quite remember this bit, actually.
I just don't want to go home. I just really don't want to go back to the bedsit.
How you feeling?
Terrified. Absolutely terrified.
You're obviously one of a kind and so unique as an artist. When you perform, your heart and soul, you throw it out there, and that's like my favorite attribute of an artist. What I'm concerned about, honestly, James, is I just don't know if this competition is for you.
whole, she... I mean, it's a fair comment based on, obviously, what she knew. However, how wrong was she? So, by the way, that was said in the most... That was the nicest. That was just more of a jesty comment, not a criticism to Nicole, because I really value her. Anyway, not hating, just... Anyway.
I don't know if you're going to be able to be strong enough to deal with the monster that the industry can be. I've had to make a decision. There's only three people that I can take with me through to the live shows, and... James, it's not good news. It's freaking amazing news! This life is here.
It's his face. He's, I was gonna say his little face. His face then, and it just shows how much it means to him, which is awesome. So.
Oh my god.
Good for you, Daddy.
Oh. Thank you. Oh my god.
How'd you feel?
I'm complete. Really complete. Over the moon happy.
It's a lovely way of putting it, isn't it?
Fruit of the live shows. Don't sound too happy. Thank you.
Right, that's a perfect point to stop on that then, isn't it? So, I mean, I don't need to, I think I did enough talking throughout that episode, so you can get my ideas. But yeah, really interested to know your thoughts. Obviously, for those massive James Arthur fans, and for those that have, I guess, only just started following him, obviously reminiscing of back then on what it was like, it sort of brings back all these floods of memories from when I watched him. And yeah, it's amazing how much he's changed. But what I like is the fact that he may have grown as an individual, and obviously maybe visually, effect wise, changed, obviously grown into a man, but he's still that genuine, humble bloke that you see on the shows. You know how much it means to him, and yeah, I like the sincerity of him and his honesty, and he's kept true to his word. He hasn't conformed to society. He's never shied away from him, and trying to meet the world's needs, if you like. So anyway, I think that's it for today. So thank you so much for tuning in. Really appreciate the support. If you're new to the channel, then thank you so much for tuning in. Please hit that subscribe button. If you're interested in comments, and check out the comment section below, because people, I'm sure, will comment. If you would comment, that'd be great. And if you did like the video, then please hit that like button, and I would really appreciate that. So thank you so much for tuning in, and stay tuned for more live reactions. Thank you. Bye bye.